Morning. Minister to us this morning, oh God. Reach us this morning in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you this morning in the name of Jesus. Let me go straight to it so that we can maximize our time. Thank you, woman of God, Victoria. I'm blessed to have you on the line. I'm blessed to have my sister Promise. I'm blessed to have all of you from South Africa and different parts of the world. God bless you this morning. Okay, I'll be reading from the book of Psalms 43. Psalms 43. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Psalms 43, verse 5. Today will be empowering our human spirit. Hallelujah. Because many human spirits today, they have been tainted. They have been tainted. And Satan tainted it. When he tainted it, then he captured it with. And when he captured it, he caged the spirit. And when he cages spirit, we begin to struggle while on earth. When he cages human spirit, people's prayers cannot be connected to God. When he cages the human spirit, the whole system is broken because it should be the inner man that leads us and not the flesh. When the flesh leads us, we are in trouble. But if the spirit is alive in Christ Jesus, the spirit cannot be bound. The Bible said the wind will blow where it listed. When our spirit is alive in Christ, we will blow where we list. We will go in the direction we want. We will become more than conquerors. The Bible said we'll be led by the Spirit. And anyone who is led by the Spirit is a son of God. That's why we're bringing this prayer, to empower our human spirit to dominate, to take over. Oh, many human spirits, they are trapped. They are trapped inside the body. Instead of the body to be ruled by the human spirit, our spirits now are being trapped. They are being trapped, and we are dragging them along. If our spirits are alive in Christ, we become spirit beings. We become spirit beings like Christ Jesus. A spirit cannot die. A spirit cannot be oppressed. A spirit cannot be tormented if it is empowered by God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So your spirit is you, the real you is your spirit. It's the invisible part that you don't see. Your flesh, the Bible says the flesh profit nothing, but the spirit gave life. The flesh, as long as we live in this world, in our flesh and in our bodies, and our bodies rule us, we will not profit much, but the spirit will give us life. Hallelujah. Let me begin to cut into the scripture as we take engage in our prayer. Hallelujah. In Psalms 43, verse 5, it says, "Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Why art thou discouraged within me? Why art thou disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall praise him who is the health of my countenance." He says, why, my soul, are you cast down? Why are you disquieted? Why, my spirit, are you acting like this? Why, my human spirit, are you discouraged? Why are you down? Why are you, instead of you sowing, instead of you being empowered, instead of you operating in visions, instead of you being full of faith, instead of you being fearless, my human spirit, you are discouraged inside of me. Why? Mandaraba shandaraba sendrebe, wherever you are right now this morning, I want you to begin to pray for your human spirit. The Bible says the spirit of a man is the candle of the Lord. God is looking for the spirit. The Bible says God goes to and fro this earth, seeking to show himself strong to some people. He's looking into the spirit. He's looking to your spirit. But if your spirit is sad, if your spirit is depressed, if your spirit is discouraged, if your spirit is full of unbelief, if your spirit contains the elements of this world, the traces of this world. It can be effective in prayer. It can be effective to rule. It can be effective to take over. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There was a time that I was praying for somebody, and God helped me to see where the spirit of the individual was. The person was thinking he was living, but I saw that spirit of that individual being held bound somewhere under the earth, held bound somewhere. When you are held bound under the earth, you can't be effective. When the enemy catches your spirit, you can't even pray. Your prayer communication becomes a struggle. When your spirit is captured, you can't be released to do effective things for the kingdom of God. I begin to pray this morning for you. Mandara baba baba shandara baba. Mandara baba baba shandara baba mandara baba baba.